Radio Corex, les corridors d'exportation de la FCCQ. Votre marché est plus grand que vous ne le pensez.
Bonjour et bienvenue à cet autre épisode de Radio Corex. Je m'entretiens aujourd'hui avec Stephen Tapp. Stephen Tapp est économiste en chef adjoint à Exportation et Développement Canada, EDC. Précision, nous parlons en date du 18 avril et puisqu'il est question d'exportation et notamment vers les États-Unis, vous, les auditeurs et auditrices, comprendrez qu'il peut y avoir du mouvement entre-temps et au moment où vous écouterez ce segment. Mais toujours est-il qu'il faut faire le point et c'est ce que je fais à l'instant avec M. Tapp. So, Mr. Tapp, hello.
Hi, how are you?
And I'm very fine. Welcome to our radio. Of course, these are turbulent times, we should say, regarding the U.S. economy and the way Canadian exporters might deal with that. First, could you tell us what is EDC's outlook for the U.S. economy?
Sure. Yeah, I can start first before just with a sort of a piece on the global. I think one of the surprising things over the past 2 years, we've seen global economic growth has strengthened quite a lot. It has spread to more countries across the world, and we've seen it pretty consistently do better than forecasters expected. So that the global economic outlook is good and is improving. This is all happening in the context of some heightened concerns about the U.S. protectionism.
Now that's the least we can say, of course.
Yes, but in our most recent outlook, us as well as some other forecasters, so EDCs, we've increased our outlook for the global economy, and that's largely coming from what's happening south of the border, so on the U.S. as well as Europe. So we think that the U.S. Will grow overall at about 3% or so this year and next year, which is a good thing and good sign for Canada. So the U.S. numbers are doing well. Labor market's improving. We see some boost coming from government spending and tax cuts south of the border. Capacity that was around is being used up, and so there's more investment happening. So really, I would say overall that the global outlook is pretty positive right now. Despite what you read in the paper, despite the media coverage of some of these events, and the U.S. economy itself is quite positive as well.
So this are really good news for Canadian exporters.
Yeah, I would say when we look back, we do a forecast for the export side in Canada as well as the provincial level. And our exports in 2017, we fared reasonably well. On a nominal basis, rebounding energy prices helped lift things up. And going forward for this year, we expect growth about 5%, next year around 4% or so. I should say we haven't started the year off, on a great note. So in the more high-frequency indicators, January, February, things have been held back a little bit by temporary auto plant shutdowns or rail backlogs, but we expect trade and exports to improve throughout the year. We've seen diversification. So we've seen exports growing faster to emerging markets as opposed to developing markets. And when we talk to exporters on the road and through our trade confidence index, we see more or less that people aren't panicked about NAFTA. They're watching NAFTA. They're concerned about NAFTA developments, but they're not panicked about it. And on the whole, the Canadian exporters are pretty optimistic about the global growth that they're seeing.
Could you focus now on Quebec exports? Quebec is doing well. The economy is in good shape. The people here, the entrepreneurs, take the opportunity that's opening to them.
Yes, I would say for sure Quebec is a good news story. Exports are expected to do quite well in 2018. We've seen a boost in terms of on the industry side, so improvements in aerospace. So we see production ramping up, some high-value production there. Mining and metals industries where prices have improved. I mentioned the U.S. outlook is pretty strong. And we have a new trade agreement with the European Union. So I think for Quebec exporters, things are looking pretty good. We're expecting growth of about 8% in exports from Quebec this year. And when you look through all the provinces, Quebec's actually second in second place. So that's doing quite well in Quebec.
Here, the SME, the small and medium enterprise, are very important. There are quite several of them, and many are taking the path of exportation. That's what they've been told. They should jump into it. But are there patterns there? Are exporting patterns different than for the larger firms?
I would say in general, SME trade and large firm trade, there are some differences when we look through the data. One thing we know for sure is that exporters, on average, exporters are performing better than those that don't export. That's true for small firms. It's true for large firms. One of the things that is important, though, is that some of these trade costs, so the idea that you need to gather market knowledge or get some financing, these trade costs can be disproportionately heavier for small firms. So as a result of that, we see small firms in general, they're less likely to export. They export smaller values on average. They don't reach as many markets as some of the big firms. And there's also some differences in terms of the industrial composition. So small firms are less active in the high value sectors like manufacturing, oil and gas, professional services. In terms of their patterns, they often start out in the U.S. market, so the closest market by where it's typically easier and closer to sell things. But we're also seeing some new patterns going forward of these born global firms. And these are a lot of small firms where there's some fast growth, a big emphasis on services as opposed to goods trade, and some digital trade. So we're seeing some opportunities and some improvements from SMEs.
And we could talk a lot, go on longer on this conversation, but we're going to the end. And we could not end without talking about the hot issue right now, which is NAFTA. What's happening in these renegotiations? Are they really going well? Could we imagine a happy ending, happy end with that?
Well, we could. So the talk started out in August 2017 at the request of the Americans. We've had seven rounds of talks so far. There's basically about 30 different issues and 30 different chapters that are being discussed. But we can really bundle them down into there are some things that are on kind of North American modernization. So these are fast track issues, things for provisions for small and medium-sized enterprises that we just discussed. How do we make their trade more efficient and how do we incorporate more of them? Ways to make sure that standards are more consistent across countries. Those modernization agenda issues are moving quickly. The real big issues that are sort of the elephant in the room would be this U.S. rebalancing side of things, where we've got a slower track and much more controversial issues. So rules on autos, as an example, for how much content you need to trade duty-free in North America, that's been a big sticking point. Dispute settlement systems, whether we'll keep those or change those. Sunset clauses, those types of issues. So on the U.S. rebalancing side, where they really have a stronger interest in changing rules, we've seen slower progress. But I'm just reading, as you said, we're here in mid-April, but we now have, of those 30, about 10 chapters have been substantively completed. So we're making some solid progress. We think, and there's been speculation that an agreement in principle could be reached shortly before the elections coming up in Mexico. But EDC Economics really expects that there will be a NAFTA 2.0 and it will eventually be reached. Certainly there's uncertainty about the timelines of those types of things, but there's a lot of business interest, public and support for the deal and for continued North American relationships, and we think that we'll see this through.
So there are reasons to be optimistic. So, Mr. Stephen Tapp, you are the Deputy Chief Economist at EDC, or Exportation et Développement Canada. Merci beaucoup. Thank you so much for this interview.
Merci beaucoup et bonne journée.
Radio Corex, les corridors d'exportation de la FCCQ. Votre marché est plus grand que vous ne le pensez.